Hi friends, welcome to the class of formal language and automata theory. In the previous lecture we have seen what is finite automata, what are the types of representations of finite automata. Now we'll see types of finite automata. So here basically we'll divide it into two parts. That is, first one is deterministic finite automata and the second one is non-deterministic. So in this first one, deterministic finite automata, what is this DFA? You see this sentence, you can understand easily. In this finite automata, for every state there exist all input paths exactly once. So all input paths exactly once. Let me take an example. So here if you consider this, here you have three states Q0, Q1, Q2. So what is Q0 to 0? That means what it is asking is every state there exist all input paths. So here what are the states I am writing here? The states are Q0, Q1, Q2 and the inputs are given by sigma, that is 0, 1. So in DFA the rule is for every state there should be exactly one input path. That means Q0 to 0 you should have Q0 to 1, Q1 to 0, Q1 to 1. Q2 to 0, Q2 to 1 and the output must be only one state. Let us consider here. Q0 to 0, yes, there is a path. And Q0 to 1, yes, there is a path. And Q1 to 0, yes, there is a path. Q1 to 1, of course, going to the self loop. And Q2 to 0, yes, you have. Q2 to 1, yes, you have. And not only this, you can observe here if I give Q0 to 1, where it is going? Q1. Only one state, it should not go more than one. Let us suppose if I give Q0 to 1, it is going to Q1 as well as it is going to Q2, then I cannot call it as a deterministic finite automata. So for every state, there exist all input paths and also exactly once. So that is the thing here in DFA, that is a constraint we need to follow for DFA. Finite state machine that accepts and rejects the strings of symbols and produces a unique computation. That's why, what is unique computation? That means if I give Q0 to 0, it is going to one unique state, it is not going to another state. So of the automata for each input string. So like this arrangement you will have in your deterministic finite automata. On the other hand, the second one is non-deterministic finite automata. So where it does not need to obey the above restriction, that means it can have any number of inputs, any number of output states also, and if the input every state there exists input path, there may not exist the input path. Consider this example. Here you can observe what is Q0 to 0. So Q0 to 0, it is going to Q0. Okay, what is Q0 to 1? If I give Q0 to 1, it is going to Q0, and not only that, if I give Q0, it is going to Q1 also. That means if I give Q0 to 1, here it is going to not only Q0 as well as Q1. So like this, it may not have in your deterministic finite automata. Whereas in non-deterministic finite automata, there are no rules like this. So you can have like this. Now I cannot call this as the deterministic, I call it as the non-deterministic finite automata. And one more thing you can observe here, Q1 to 0 you have path, Q1 to 1, yes, okay. But whereas Q2 to 0, is there any path? There is no path. So like this you have in NFA. You may have path, you may not have path, you may have more than one paths for the same input also. So like this the arrangement you call it as non-deterministic. Whereas in deterministic you have a constraints like this, for every state there exist all input paths that are exactly ones. Whereas in non-deterministic there are no restrictions. There is a fixed number of states, but we can be in multiple states at one time. That is what I explained here. Whereas in Q0 to 1, I may be in Q0, I may be in Q1, like this. In particular, every DFA is also an NFA, but not vice versa. So from this, we can conclude that every DFA, I call it as NFA, but whereas NFA, I cannot call it as DFA. So NFAs are more expensive than DFA. So for a particular string, if I want to find, whereas in DFA, there is exactly one path, that's why we'll follow that path. Whereas in NFA, you may have more than one path. That's why I need to check all the paths. So that's why it is more expensive. In general, we can see if you want to go to some destination, if you have only one path, you can follow that path. But if you have more than one path, you need to check which path is the correct one. Now you can observe the tuple notation difference also for DFA. Of course, phi tuple, NFA also phi tuple, everything is same, except you can observe here. Of course, Q is the same, sigma same, whereas Q naught is same, F is also same. But whereas your mapping function, you can observe here, Q, that is Q naught, like this we can write, low of some state and some input. I'll take it as something like 0. It will go to some other state, some QF or some state. Only one state you will find here is a transition. Whereas in NFA, Q cross sigma, that means 2 power Q. That means it may go for any number of states. That means if I give, it may exist a number of states. So that is only the difference. That's why here 2 power Q. So you may have a doubt that why it is 2 power Q. So let us consider one example here. In our example, let us suppose if I say Q naught to 0, let us suppose if I want to write Q naught to 0, what are the number of options I may have? If I ask you, you may say that you may have any state for it. Let us suppose Q naught to 0, maybe there is no path. That is a one thing. And Q naught to 0, if I give, it may go to Q naught, or it may go to Q1, or it may go to Q2. Or else Q naught to 0, if I give, it may go to Q naught as well as Q1, or it may go to Q naught as well as Q2, or it may go to Q1 comma Q2, or it may go to all the states Q naught, Q1, Q2. See, for one Q naught to 0, if I ask you, these many possibilities I may find in NFA, whereas in DFA it's not like that. It must be only one state. So how many possibilities are there? If I have three states here, totally you can count here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. So now if I have 3, I am getting 2 power 3 number of possibilities I am getting. So that's why I have given here. So 2 power Q, maybe number of output states I may find. So this is what here happens when you consider for NFA. Now language acceptance. So what is this language acceptance? That means here you need to check out what are the strings accepted by the given finite automata. We have seen a number of finite automata till now. Now what are the strings that are accepted by the finite automata? We'll see now. I'll take one example. Now this is the finite automata I have given. What are the strings accepted by this finite automata? Of course, I have to represent this with a language. So now how I can consider is, acceptance is always we'll consider as, when you take a string, the string final acceptance, finally, when you trace each symbol of a string in sequential manner, at the end, it has to go for final state. Like if I take Q naught to 0, if I take, where it is going? Q naught itself. Whereas Q naught to 1, if I take, it is going to Q1. That means if I take a one string like symbol 1, it is going to Q1. So final state. So that's why 1 is accepted by this finite automata. Now if I consider one more example, that is 0, 1, will it accept? You check it out. So how we need to start actually? So you need to start from Q naught. Initially Q naught to 0. What is Q naught to 0? You are going to Q naught. Now whatever the resultant state you are getting, from that you take the next symbol. Q naught to 1. What is Q naught to 1? You are going to Q1. So now the answer is Q1. So now symbols are over. What is this state? Q1. So check out, is it final state? Yes. So now this string will be accepted. Like this we need to consider. Take another one like 0, 1, 1, if I consider. Let us see. Starting from Q naught, Q naught to 0, Q naught itself. Now Q naught to 1, it is going to Q1. Now Q1 to 1, where is Q1 to 1 state? There is no Q1 to 1 state. So that's why this 0, 1, 1 will not be accepted. Like this we need to find. The language of a DFA is a set of all strings over sigma starting from Q naught and following the transitions as the string is read from left to right. That means you need to read the string from left to right, will reach some accepting state. Finally, it has to go for accepting state. If you take a W in the sense, it's a word where it belongs to finally a state P, where it has to belongs to final state. Let us consider one more, like 001. Will it accept? Yes. Why? Because Q naught to 0, Q naught, again Q naught to 0, Q naught, again Q naught to 1. Yes, Q1. So string is over and it is going to the final state. Like this we can consider. So you may have some other strings also like this. Now, what is the language that consisting all these strings for this respective finite automata? We'll see some more examples. So now if you consider this one, what is the language accepted by this? So I'm checking first. So if I give 01, let us take 01 means, so Q naught to 0, where it is going Q naught, then Q naught to 1, Q1. Q1 is the final state, yes, accepted. Now let us consider 011. What happens for 011? Q naught to 0, Q naught only. Now Q naught to 1, Q1. Now Q1 to 1. What is Q1 to 1? Now you can see this path, Q naught. So finally it is going to Q naught. What is Q naught? Is it a final state? No. So that's why 011 will not be accepted by this finite automata. So you can consider 0100. What happens? You can see. So starting from Q naught to 0, Q naught. Next Q naught to 1, it will goes to Q1. Q1 to 0, this 0, Q1, and again Q1 to 0, again to Q1. So Q1, finally you are going, Q1 is the final state, that's why 0100 is a string that is accepted by this finite automata. You can check like this, and some other strings you can see 100 or 10, everything will be accepted. And you can consider this one also. I'll take a string like 10011. We'll check this one. So starting from Q naught to 1, directly Q1, and Q1 to 0, Q1, and again Q1 to 0, Q1. Now Q1 to 1. What is Q1 to 1? Q0. Now Q0 to 1 going to Q1. So final result is Q1, which is a final state. That's why this is also accepted. Like this, so many strings will be accepted by this finite automata. Now you can see for this one, what are the strings accepted? So initially, now you can observe here, initial state itself is the final state. So whenever you find initial state itself is the final state, your conclusion is, first of all, the finite automata will accept, that means without taking any symbol, it is going to the final state. That means initial state itself is the final state, means without taking any symbol. That means we need to include epsilon in the language. That you need to remember whenever you find initial state itself is the final state. Now, what are the other things it will accept? 0, yes, it will accept, because Q0 to 0, it is going to Q0. What is Q0? Final state. What about 01? Q0 to 0, then Q0 to 1, Q1. Q1 is not a final state, no? So that's why this will not be accepted. What about 10? So Q0 to 1, Q1, Q1 to 0, Q0. So finally you are going to Q0, final state, this will be accepted. So like this you can take again 110, yes, accepted. 1100, yes, accepted. Like this you have. Now coming to this one, so here you have two final state. That means your input, if it goes to Q1, then it is accepted, or else it goes to Q2, then also it will accept. So first thing, what about a symbol 1? So Q0 to 1, Q1, final state, yes, accepting. 10. Q0 to 1, Q1, Q1 to 0, Q2, yes, final state, accepting. What about this 01? So Q0 to 0, Q0, Q0 to 1, Q1, yes, final state, accepted. What about 010? So 0, then Q0 to 1, Q1, Q1 to 0, Q2, yes, accepted. So like this you have. If I give 00, what happens? So Q0 to 0, Q0, again Q0 to 0, Q0, where Q0 is not a final state here, so will not be accepted. So like this you can consider, and other strings, so many are there. 1 1 will be accepted, 1 0 0, yes, accepted, like this. So like this we can find. And remember the one point, that for a particular string, if you trace each symbol one by one, finally it has to go to a state which is the final state, then only you can say that particular string is accepted by the finite automata. So in the next classes we'll find how to construct deterministic finite automatas for particular problems, how easily you can find it out, we'll see. Thank you.